rocking with the number one podcast in Flint, Michigan. Flint After Dark. We speak for the streets. Hosted by your boy Terrence Sales. We speak for the streets. Welcome to Flint Town City. 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 Welcome to Flint Town City.
Somebody told a lie one day. They couched it in language. They made everything black, ugly, and evil. Look in your dictionary and see the synonyms of the word black. Always something degrading and low and sinister. Look at the word white, it's always something pure. But I want to get the language right tonight. I want to get the language so right that everybody here will cry out, yes, I'm black, I'm proud of it, I'm black and beautiful.
Yo, yo. LPZ, is you in the motherfucking building?
In the building with bells on.
Man. Black History Month.
It is.
The fastest month. The fastest month on record. Watch how fast this month go.
Yeah, it's always overshadowed by some other shit too. HIV, crack, you know what I'm saying? LBGT, OBAs, you know what I'm saying? We need our own shit without any interruptions, okay?
Right. Hey man, hold on.
For real.
Hey LPZ, let me clear something up right quick, man. Let me do it without being too nasty. I got a few complaints last week. Somebody told me, a couple people told me I went off subject. You know what I'm saying? I can take criticism. I can take that. You know what I mean? But what happened was I usually go and do my news, get my news off because I got an itinerary on here. And I'm going to get my itinerary on here off. And before we go into the subject, usually we've been doing this a couple months now. Me and LPZ been doing this, and that's what happens, man. So I'm gonna get my news off. I'm not going off subject, and if I do, who gives a fuck? This Flint After Dark, and my man San Lawrence voice, we do what the fuck we want to do on here. You know what I mean? We're gonna get y'all people the good information, stuff y'all need to know and hear. And we're going to have a great subject every week, man. That's all I want to say about that, man. With that being said, the topic of the day is, sabotaging a black man, a powerful black man like T.I. and Bill Cosby, man. You know what I mean? They on the list. It's a list that they got that they destroy certain black men of power, and that gives back to the community and stuff like that. And I truly believe T.I., Tip Harris, and Bill Cosby, as you know what I mean, is a tool that was on the list and being targeted, man. Me and LPZ call it the Me Too era. You know what I'm saying? So we're going to get into that later, a little later. Right now, we're going to get a little news going. We're going to get a little news going here. You remember, LPZ, you remember Saved by the Bell?
Yes, definitely remember Saved by the Bell. It was one of the greatest shows ever.
My man, Shriek, Dustin Diamond, a.k.a. Screech. Yeah. Man, he passed away, man. He had cancer. They say he passed away quick too. He just found out about it, and it took him off the game, man. I love that show, man. It lasted like 13 seasons, man. I used to have a crush on the black chick. What was her name?
Everybody did. Lark.
Yeah. Lark, I had a crush. Lark. I had a crush on her. Praying for I don't know. I wonder how she looked. You know they say black don't crack.
Yeah, man. I bet she got a friends only page.
I bet she do too.
Hey,
yeah, you
gotta go look that up. I like that shit.
Okay, use the good. Hey, use the good lotion. Use the lotion with aloe vera in it. Hey, look, man.
The freak.
Hey, Lil Durk. His album The Voice Deluxe moved 70,000 units last week, and it's expected to move 65 to 75 more. His album number 2 on the billboards. So I'll be telling y'all boys, work hard, man. The rap game ain't dead, man. It's about your marketing and the engine you have behind you. And he definitely has an engine behind you, man. Behind him, excuse me. Rihanna, man.
Excuse me.
Yeah, go ahead, sir. Go ahead.
Yeah. Just note to the little rappers and shit. Can we get some fucking passion back into music and shit? Everybody sound like they rap the shit off the goddamn cell phone. And if I could in the trap, it would, should. And no passion involved at all, no rhyme skill. Can we get back to the art of being creative? That's all I'm saying. You know,
cool.
And I guarantee you, this is about to be a great year for rap music and rappers, period. You know what I'm saying? 2021 and going forward. You know, so I'm excited.
Yeah, I think it's going to be a great year, too. 2021 going to be the year, man.
It's going to be a big turnaround.
Yeah.
Right. Cool. And then we know too much now.
Right.
You know, so we're not looking for major labels to come and save us.
Exactly. You
know, we
don't need Diddy the labels no more. You know, stay independent.
Yeah, we got Diddy and Jay now. So, hey, that's it. That's all we need. We run our shit through them.
My man, nephew, Wayne Jay, the Coochie Man, he tweeted out something today. I ain't heard from him in a minute. And he was like, he in L.A., and he was thanking all the people that supported him, and he was thinking that he was able to provide and take care of his family off rap, and he also said he glad he stayed independent, and he exactly right. You don't need no record companies no more, man. All you gotta do is have your paperwork in order, and everything else will follow. And great marketing. You know what I mean? And you good, man. You motherfucking good. But Rihanna, man, the singer, my baby, Rihanna rips Kentucky AG Daniel Cameron about that Breonna Taylor shit, man. She drug his ass on Twitter. She lit his ass up, man. People still mad about that shit, man. You know what I mean? I know Breonna Taylor got that little $12 million, but it ain't gonna bring her back. They still need justice, man. And with motherfuckers like Daniel Cameron, it ain't gonna be too much justice, sir, man. You know what I mean? That shit crazy, man.
Yeah, he piece of shit.
He a piece of shit. Right. Hey, look, I got two big dummies for the day. The leader of the Proud Boys, he turned out to be a fucking informant and a rat. And we got Chad Willer, man. If y'all don't know who that is, that's the white boy, man, that played for the Seahawks. Well, he don't play for them no more. His dumb ass got kicked off the team. Hold on a second.
Yeah. Dummy. You big dummy. You big dummy. You big dummy.
You big cold-blooded dummy. You big dummy, see what you did? Oh, no, you big dummy.
Listen, man, I know LPZ, me and you touched on this, and you was like, just because it was a sister, she knew what she was doing, fucking with the white boy. But still, bro, all I'm saying is, I investigated some more into it. He, he told her, he made her bow down. She wouldn't bow down. She wanted him to bow down to her. You know what I'm saying? This son bitch like 6'7", 6'8". 300 pounds, man.
Yeah.
I'm sure the sister wasn't that big, man. You know what I'm saying? Maybe 140 pounds at the most.
Shit the hell out of me. Is this not America? You can't make a bitch bow down to you no more?
Man, fuck that, man.
You have bitches on Sunday? No. It's my constitutional right to beat my wife up on Sunday.
Man.
Read. It's true. Make America great again.
Well, anyway, he's a big dummy. He had to post a bond of $400,000, and he lost his job in the NFL. You know that's some money. You know he took a drastic pay cut. So he the big dummy for blowing it all for some pussy, man. Whether she was white or black, he was a big dummy.
No, it wasn't behind no pussy. No, that was some ego tripping. He had some godly effect going on. And he pulled that shit at the wrong time with the wrong somebody.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So, you know, celebrities are under attack right now. And you definitely have to watch what the fuck you do in the public eye. Because everything that you do is subject to be objectified by someone. You see what I'm saying? Everybody gets to form an opinion. And all those opinions are not going to go into your favor. So you really have to be careful about what is put out into the universe. You know what I'm saying? I mean, if, you know, you're doing freaky shit and T.I. and Tiny shit, you know what I'm saying? And then you become political, and then you start speaking for the black race and shit like that, then you become a target. Then everything that you have ever done in your life, you know what I'm saying, is subject to come back up. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
But, I mean, this is why don't nobody want to be a leader. You know what I mean? Because don't nobody want their shit to be tossed up.
It's a lot of shit comes with being a leader.
Because of the shit they do.
Right.
So I applaud people like T.I. that's willing to stand up for the shit.
Salute, T.I.
You know what I'm saying?
Hey.
He got on his path.
Hold on, man. The second part. The leader of the Proud Boys. The right-winger extremist group. He motherfucker turned out to be a rat informant, man. But some old fried shit he did in 2012. He gonna inform on motherfuckers, man. But you the leader of supposed to be a right winger extremist group. Y'all supposed to be tough, man. Y'all some suckers for real now, man. I didn't respect y'all anyway. Y'all the big dummies, man. Got a fucking informant for y'all leader. Big dummies.
Fucking informant
covering
all shapes and sizes.
Man, okay, but he definitely won. I don't give a fuck what shape and size they come in. Shit, don't let me find out you part of the Proud Boys. You so taking up with them motherfuckers.
Nigga just fuck around, pull his phone out, and do some shit on Snapchat, and then fucked up, got a nigga caught up on some shit. You know what I'm saying?
Hey.
You know what I'm saying?
They gave motherfuckers
the spy phone. They talking, it's the camera phone. No, bitch, that's the spy phone. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Remember how you used to sneak out, be out on a date with another bitch, and then if another motherfucker saw you, you can at least lie and play it against, bitch, you didn't see what the fuck you thought you saw. Shit,
exactly.
Nowadays, motherfuckers got pictures, video, motherfucking, what's that? iPhone makes an excellent camera.
Oh, yeah. You can make a movie with that bitch. Hey, man. Right. Hey, man. Georgia cops caught on body cam video making racist comments of Stacey Abrams, Rashad Brooks, and Keisha Lance Bottoms, man. That's the mayor of Atlanta. Gene Allman has resigned, and John what's this? Brooks was fired as body cam footage surfaced of them using racial slurs and talking about black people, man. That's why I want y'all to stop falling for the smoke and mirrors, man. Stop falling for that banana in the tailpipe shit. I know LPZ don't play the nigga card, but man, this is what they feel about us. No matter what, we still a nigga, man. You know what I mean? What you got to say about that?
Make America great again. Go down to your local Dodge. Buy your trip. Come see me. Cowboy Pete.
Oh.
That's what I say about that shit, man.
I know some shit that'll cheer you up. America. Listen, I know some shit that you'll like. I forgot about this. They said it was some type of raid or something down in Florida. I don't know what the raid was for. I don't know if it's drugs, but two FBI agents was killed when they stormed the building. They lit their ass up. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Motherfuckers getting tired of them lighting them up. They gonna make their family feel. You know what I mean? I know you would like that shit. You know what I mean? I forgot about that. You know what I'm saying? Hey, man. Mm-hmm. Outrage. A 9-year-old black girl was pepper sprayed by the Rochester, New York police, man. After refusing to get out the patrol car, man. Huh?
I seen the whole clip. Hold on.
Okay.
I seen the whole clip.
Okay.
And it was fucked up from the get-go because the mama stabbed the daddy.
Okay.
So the 9-year-old called the police.
Okay.
The mama was trying to get the daughter to come back into the house, and she wouldn't go because she was saying her mama stabbed her daddy and her daddy was bleeding.
Wow. Right?
Nobody's paying attention to this little girl. So they ended up putting the little, so the mama like, come here, you little motherfucker, you better take your ass to the house before I beat the shit out you. She tried to fight her daughter and everything.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
The police took the little girl, put the little girl in the car. The little girl was screaming and hollering so bad because nobody was paying attention to what the fuck she was saying. So as it kept escalating and the women were escalating, then they decided to pepper spray her ass because they felt like she was just being irate. And then the police officer was like, you're acting like a real little kid right now. And she's like, I am a little kid.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And so the little girl ended up getting pepper sprayed. Those women are completely wrong for that shit. But that just shows you how the evolution of women has happened to where they don't even have sympathy for each other anymore as women. They don't even feel a motherly vibe for a fucking child anymore. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You're telling me that there are all these grown-ass women on the scene and nobody can calm themselves down enough to find out what it is the child is trying to say or what the child is needing or that they even gave a fuck. Everybody out there was full of emotion, you know what I'm saying, and not the right emotion either.
Right.
Like, where the fuck is your womanhood at? Wow. Are we so confused as to who we are that we don't even know how to respond to each other? A man is so confused about his sexuality, he don't know when to be a man to a young man?
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
To where a mother is so fucked up about her sexuality, she don't know when to be catering and loving to another young woman that needs that shit? Like, come on now.
Right.
That shit is fucking deep.
That shit
deep. You
know
what I mean? Because, see, if those two officers wasn't doing that aggressive-ass, full-of-testosterone-type job, you know what I'm saying, they wouldn't respond that way. I think if they were, like, nurses or something like that, they would have responded in a different way. But because, you know what I'm saying, this whole little I want to be what a man is and a man want to be what a woman is and everybody want to blur the motherfucking lines and shit, now we having a complete, identity crisis to where we're mishandling our children.
Yeah, that'll happen.
And then our children
the identity crisis. That should have happened,
yeah.
Man.
And then the kids got to deal with it. And then motherfuckers, you know, like, and then we change our way of life or living due to social And we always use the word they to describe an entity that no one knows exists. Well, they say it's cool. Well, they say that you can do this. And you know they ain't going to let you do that.
Right.
Man, y'all people better start thinking for yourselves and quit being letting this world raise you.
Yep. Hey,
on the next thing, before I get upset. I don't want to get upset, start preaching.
Yeah.
I'm about to catch the Holy Ghost.
Yeah, take your drink of water, man. Hey,
I took your drink of water, and yeah.
Let's move on, man. Let's move on. Hey, but that's a fucked up situation. Hey, look, you know this pandemic shit going, so I like to turn people on to different TV episodes and movies. For Life back on.
Yeah, you know, I'm a fan of For Life. I
that's
that
my
show.
Shit.
I watch
it all the time. Hey, LPZ, I shed a tear.
Season has crying every show.
Every episode, I shed a tear, man.
Man, you know every episode, I cry like a motherfucker, man. I was feeling that shit.
Hey, man. Shout out to 50 Cent, man, for bringing that shit to life, man. Shout out to 50, man.
What's up, big bro? You doing your goddamn thing, man. We are enjoying the change of lanes.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, we need some more music, but we are definitely enjoying the change of lanes, man.
Oh, yeah, we need that. Hey, but you know what, though? LPZ, that shit deep because this man come home after doing 9 years for some shit he didn't do. And then come to find out, he went in his wife's phone, and she fucking with his best friend. Man, that's a hard pill to swallow, bro.
No.
You know what I mean?
She had been fucking with his best friend.
Yeah, they forever. Since he,
you know
not
what
before
saying?
He left.
After the fact, you know what I'm saying? Okay, my man went on, because nobody thought the dude was going to get out of jail, so they wrote his ass
right.
off.
They thought, right,
you know
he wasn't
going to
get out. That's understandable, but it ain't understandable.
Let's just be real. Bitches write your ass off after 9 fucking weeks, nigga.
But let's just be real with this. Let's just be real with this. It's about 100 million niggas in the world. Why would you have to fuck with my mans? I understand you're not going to be faithful. A woman, she ain't going to be faithful if you're not locked up. So you know when you get locked up, she's gonna do her. She gonna do her regardless.
Hey, check this out though. You know, and I'm not justifying that whole situation because believe me, I felt it too. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you had to feel that.
You're supposed to be my best friend. You know what I'm saying? And then I go to prison for some shit I didn't do. You know, you supposed to believe in me and help me get out this shit. You know what I'm saying? But you gave up on me to be fucking on my wife. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
And now you done moved into my whole house. You done moved my family out. And you know what I'm saying? And all this shit. So trust me, I understand all those emotions. But then at the same time, when he goes away to prison, the best friend is the closest man to her. Okay? And while he's trying to be supportive of his best friend and his wife and her daughter, they build the bond there. When they start spending time and she begins to get comfortable with him.
Man.
Hold on, let me say my piece. So she begins to get comfortable with him. So when she does turn to a man, because at some point that motherfucker gonna get to throbbing. When she goes to turn to a man, she's gonna turn to the one closest to her in the first place. It's just something that happens by nature. You know what I'm saying? Shit, you put two people, a man and a woman, in a room long enough, they don't fuck. I don't give a fuck if they don't like each other or if they white and black or pink and Indian. Doesn't even fucking matter. It's going to happen.
All right, man. Well,
it's natural. But
y'all,
that situation.
Let's move on, man.
That's
we're making a whole subject out of this. Hey, man. I feel you.
Anybody else in the world pick my best friend.
Let's move on, man.
That's how I feel about it.
Let's move on. So I'm watching the All American last night. I fuck with All American. So I usually, when it goes off, I change the channel. I think I turn to Fox News because it come on at 10 o'clock. Anyway, I didn't turn it. So a program came on right behind it. It caught my eye. And it was called Batwoman. And she black. Batwoman. She black, man. This shit fire, man. It amazed me because she was black. A black Batwoman. And this shit good, too, man. Y'all need to check that out. That shit good, man. That's on CW. That's good. And we got Snowfall. It'll be back on, I think, next week or the week after. My man, Franklin Saint, a.k.a. Ricky Ross, man. I can't wait to see what's going on, man. Because you know that story ain't never Rick Ross story, right? The real Rick Ross. Hello?
Yeah, definitely. I've heard.
Yeah, you were mute on me. You must don't fuck with it.
No, nigga. I definitely fuck with Starbucks. Snowfall.
Okay. Hey, we got another one, too. This, I need y'all to check out. Huh? I got one more for him, too.
Okay,
I got the Judith and the Black Messiah, man. It's a movie based on the Black Panthers, man. This shit, the trailer good, man. Y'all need to check that out. I think that come out on the 14th. It's called Judith and the Black Messiah, man. It looked like a good flick, man. I think the CIA or the Feds is trying to infiltrate the Black Panthers. It's good, man.
That's what they do in every situation, man.
Yeah, I know.
That's what they do in every situation. And now they got social media to turn you against your favorite person.
Yep.
They don't have to use infiltration. They use lies and cameras. For real. You get and trust me, he likes you get enough hating ass niggas.
Yeah, this brings us to the topic of the night, man. Hold on 1 second. Tip Harris, man, and Tiny Harris. They fallen victim to the Me Too syndrome, man. The same thing happened to Bill Cosby, man. It's a war on influential, powerful black men and women too. They on the list, man. They was on that list. Cause I don't believe none of the accusations that they say Tip and Tiny did, man. I love the way he came back out with his rebuttal, man. What's the name of the show? T.I.'s Family Values. And in the Bill Cosby show, they very similar because it shows it's not no ghetto. It's got people living in a mansion, people living in a nice home. The Cosby show was about the daddy was a doctor, the mom was a lawyer, was an attorney. The kids was well kept and well mannered, and they went on to college and stuff like that. Family Values shows two rich people living their life, and their kids don't want for nothing. So they very similar shows, and that's why I truly believe that they Me Too victims. You know what I'm saying? They both show two successful Black American families, man. What you got to say, LPZ?
Let's just break this down. Now,
okay.
I am a Bill Cosby advocate and shit, and I know that, you know, they slid him up under the motherfucking bridge and shit while we was blinded with the political bullshit that was going on at the time. But you have to look at this man's legacy, where he started from, where he went. First of all, he was America's greatest black comic as far as what the white man would tell you. You know what I'm saying? They love
right.
Bill Cosby. Bill was just the guy. Okay, so
right.
He made positive television. He made, tasteful jokes. You know what I'm saying? He wasn't a Richard Pryor. He wasn't an Eddie Murphy type of guy.
Nope.
You know what I'm saying? So he was more of a lighthearted comedian. He was always for his people, from Fat Albert, and he went from Fat Albert to, you know, the numerous shows, and then the Cosby Show. Then you have the Cosby Show, and the Cosby Show was a very positive show that went and did great spinoffs like Different World and other shows. But with that being said, Bill Cosby was, and still is, you ask me, America's favorite dad. They gave him that title, okay? Now, you're America's favorite dad, right? For fucking 30 years.
Right.
You go to buy CBS. What the fuck is the hang-up? Oh, there's a
problem. I think it was NBC.
Huh?
I think it was NBC.
NBC?
Yeah, it don't matter. NBC, ABC, yeah. CBS is all the same shit.
Yeah. Okay, but the thing was, he was going to buy a network. You know what I'm saying? So
right.
He's in the process of buying a network, but the problem is, this guy is not the fucking jigaboo we thought he was. You know what I'm saying? Now he's mad at Black America. Black America done fucked up. He goes on whatever talk show that was, if it was Oprah or somebody, and let Black America have it. We're like, hold on. I thought Bill Cosby was this, you know, Jell-O pudding snack, old friendly ass nigga.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? We've known Bill Cosby to be this, you know, friendly Jell-O pudding puff, silly, you know, black guy. And that's what we thought he was. And when he came off and he was pissed the fuck off at us, you know what I'm saying? He let us know he came off like a grumpy ass old man. You know what I'm saying? And that's how we wrote him off, too. Oh, Bill's just old and mad and shit. You know what I'm saying? And when the allegations came out against him, we didn't really think that it was going to go as far as it did.
I didn't.
You know what I'm saying? And the cast from the Cosbys and shit, nobody ran to his aid because, one, you didn't want the PR. You didn't want to get caught up in that, you know, talking about it and being on camera and all that shit.
Right.
Then, two, you know, you didn't know if it was actually true or not. And then when he got charged, you're like, damn, it must be some truth to this. Well, no, it was many fucking lies to that. You know what I'm saying? And they sentenced that man to death. They
yeah,
took
he's,
Bill Cosby
he, yeah.
Put
yeah,
his
he's,
ass
he, he'll never get out alive.
Right before us.
You're right. Right before our eyes.
It's quarantine. And this man went to jail for some shit that a bitch couldn't remember for 40 fucking years and all of a sudden came back to her. And
man, looking bitch.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
This shit all of a sudden came. And it's what? It's no statute. It's a limit on statutory rape. It's a limit on it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? There's,
yeah.
There's
everything
no
but murder. Everything but murder.
You know what I'm saying? So how are we charging this man for giving out Quaaludes at a party where the shit was socially acceptable at the time? That's like getting Rick Dane, resurrecting his ass, and charging him for smoking crack at the party.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yep.
It doesn't make sense, but at the same time, it had to make an impact. That was one motherfucker they took away from us, and everything that he owned
yep.
becomes a part of his estate that becomes
right.
awarded to the state,
right.
which they are stealing from him.
Right.
Fucking R. Kelly did the same shit. We was all fucked up because R. Kelly pissed on the little girl shit, right? Hold on, but this wasn't a 12-year-old girl. This wasn't a 9-year-old girl. This is a girl grown enough to get there. You know what I'm saying? And unbeknownst to you, people like to be pissed off.
Man.
If you go to Pornhub right now, people
ooh,
pissed off, you see a bunch of people getting pissed on, okay? But because it was foreign to us, it was nasty. Because, he pissed on, I can't believe R. Kelly pissing on people. I didn't know people got down like that and enjoyed the shit. But I'm saying that to say, is when we seen that, we allowed that to make us believe that what he was doing was perversive. And then when people are talking about R. Kelly and what they used to do for him, when they're saying, oh, I used to go to the high schools for R. Kelly and pick up little girls, this is a 40-year-old motherfucker talking about some shit he did 20 years ago.
I mean,
he ain't made no money since. The nigga kind of bitter, you know what I'm saying? And he's like, yeah, we used to go to high school and pick up chicks. Y'all was like 20, 21. And the chicks y'all was picking up was like 18, 19. You know what I'm saying? But it sounds bad, so I'm going to say it because it sells and people are interested in people's demise and their drama. And then he goes to jail. His estate is awarded to the state, and they take all his masters, all his music, all his cars, and all his shit. And that's fucking robbery, right? It's something. Like,
yeah.
It should be illegal. Like, you're taking all my shit. I mean, because he's not going to go out and he's not going to go in and come back shit.
Man.
None of it. You've been in prison. Did you go in and come back to your shit the way it was? So you're fucking, and then these people are, you know, head of state or speaking for the people or involved.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
Just like my man T.I. And see, now we not behind the blindfold no more. So when the shit happened with T.I., we like, oh, we see what they trying to do with that nigga. He done fucked around and said too much. And see, he done got too fucking intelligent, and then he's giving out way too much good information on his shows. And now people are gravitating towards him, not because he's a trap star, not because he's the dopest rapper, but because this nigga has a dangerous ass mind and the wordplay to put the shit on the table. You know what I'm saying? So with that being said, they want to blemish that. They want to tarnish that and take that from him by putting his bed room on display for the world to judge. And Tip, don't let that shit happen. You know what I'm saying? You ain't guilty of shit.
It's about money, man.
Fuck what everybody say about that shit. You know what I'm saying? That is in the privacy of your own home. And if people wish to run around and spread lies and shit like that, let that be on them. You know what I'm saying? But real shit, that shit's not a crime.
Hey, didn't they say?
Then they gonna put trafficking bitches.
Yeah,
none of
that's
them
deep.
Hoes said they selling pussy.
That's what, when they had time to do that. You know what I mean?
They was popping pills and drinking motherfucking champagne and shit. Bitch was popping bottles and then getting paid a salary.
Man. To piggyback off.
Get the fuck out of here.
Hold on.
You know what I'm saying? That's all I'm saying.
Before we get too far.
That's all I'm saying. That don't sound like no in slavery, trafficking type
of
shit.
You know they ain't do
that,
man. You know they ain't do that. They trying to trump up the charges, man. Make them look to what it is.
No,
hey.
It ain't trumping up the charges because there's no charges. But it's
the allegations.
That they're putting on the
trump
internet.
Up the allegations. Hey.
Yes.
Hey, hold on. I don't want to get too far. The piggyback off the Bill Cosby thing, you said he was sentenced to death, which is true, because he's old and he got health problems. It's some bullshit behind some. Why Trump didn't commute Bill Cosby, man? But he commuted Kodak Black, man, non-influential. I said non-influencer, black man. Yeah, he's a fucking young idiot. You know what I mean? And then you gonna this man of power, a Bill Cosby, which like you say was America's dad. Why wouldn't they commute his sentence, knowing he don't have that long to live and he's not a threat? You know what I mean?
When they
sentenced him to death.
When they got rid of Bill, that was from the powers that be.
Right. That was right. That call was up top.
That was from the powers that be.
Right.
And Bill, if he didn't do something that they wanted him to do, you know what I'm saying? Then they was gonna take him the fuck out.
Yeah.
But I don't know what it was that they asked of Bill that Bill refused to do.
Right.
But whatever it was in protection of us, and he went to jail for that shit and took one for the fucking team. So,
listen.
Bill need to write a book and let us know what the fuck going on.
Man.
You know what I'm saying?
And like I said, the Bill's Cosby show and the Family Values Tip Them show, they show a positive black America lifestyle, living good, living normal, you know what I mean? Not struggle at all. And I truly believe they the same way they sabotage Bill, they trying to sabotage Tilt, man. And I'm gonna tell you who better be careful, who might be next. Ice Cube. He better slow his roll. They was talking about buying a network. Him and some guy. And I don't want him to do Cube like that, man. That would crush me right there, man. You know what I mean? But then you gotta look at it like this, though. You damn if you do, you damn if you don't. Like you say, nobody wanna really be singled out as the leader because there's a lot of shit comes with that. And but you got some powerful, you know what I'm saying, influential black guys, you know what I mean, that's influenced on the community, man. And motherfuckers just gotta be careful, man. They gotta move different, man. Cause you see they got something for you. They definitely got something for you. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And
I mean, you know what? We gotta get back to living purest lives too. You know what I mean?
Cause right.
If you lived a healthy life, you wouldn't have shit you need to hide. You right. Know what I'm saying? And at this point, you know, if you're not man enough to be about whatever it is you do, whatever you do, you should not be ashamed of what you do. You know what I mean? If you whatever it is you do, be proud of what you do. So that no one ever can use that against you.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Hey, LPs, you want to play? I want to play a little piece of T.I.'s rebuttal, man. Let me, the people, I don't know for those that ain't heard it. Hold on a second. Hold on.
Guess, or imagine, it's been extremely difficult for me to remain quiet in light of all the things that transpired and all of the egregious allegations that's been tossed around about me and my wife. But it's a reason for that. And I don't mind sharing it. You see, if a person does not have any right to criminally or civilly have you in court, they have no right. The best thing they could do is get you for a defamation suit.
He continued on stating that while women, particularly black women, should be believed in, this isn't one of those instances.
Because unfortunately right now, it doesn't matter as much what they can prove you did. It matters what you can prove you didn't. You know what I mean? And that's just an unfortunate place that our society has made it to. But I want to be clear about one thing. Women who have been victimized deserve to be heard. Women, black women in particular, should be supported, protected, defended, and uplifted. However, evil has no gender. People with evil intentions have no gender. A threat comes in all shapes and sizes. I would never treat a woman the same way I would treat a threat. All right? So I think that has to be distinguished.
He also went on to share posts from an Instagram.
That's a little bit of what T.I. had to say. I respect what he said, man. He didn't run and hide. None of that shit, man. He tackled it head on, man. You got to respect that. You know what I mean? Unlike R. Kelly, who ran for 29 years. You know what I mean?
Yeah, because R. Kelly ain't no motherfucking Libra. T.I. and I happen to be Libras. We should stand up. Oh, and you a Libra too.
Without a doubt.
See?
I was a Libra before you. You know what I mean?
Bitch.
Right. You shit crazy, time, man. And I like the way he took up for his wife and he said she didn't deserve none of this. He said Tiny was a sweet person and she didn't deserve none of this, man. But it's one thing about when the man bring you out, he don't care who he hurt, sweet or not. Like he said, the devil come in all disguises, man. Evil. You know what I mean? The shit crazy, bro. I mean, I don't believe that, man. I believe they known swingers. And like you say, their bedroom shouldn't be on trial. What they do in their bedroom shouldn't be on trial. You know what I mean? And I mean, who don't like a threesome or two with their bitch, man? Keep it real. You know what I mean? Yeah. I mean, but far as man, sex trafficking. Come on, man. They had time to tie some bitches up, take them from state to state, and make them sell some pussy. Come on, man. That's some bullshit, man.
Why on national television with a camera up your ass everywhere you go?
Following you everywhere you go.
Right.
You gotta say, hold on, dog. I'm finna go take a shit. Hold on, you can't come in here. That's how they on their ass. You know what I mean? But man, it just boils down. You know, that's why I be telling.
Like I say, we live in a new age, man. And we have to get a control over the information that we take in and the shit that we allow our attention and our emotions to be behind. Because there is somebody somewhere that's orchestrating the whole thing. You know, that's why they call it an algorithm and shit. Because it had to be something that they study. So whenever they put out a post or they put out visuals and it says that we're reacting a certain way, they know what buttons to push at what certain times, because we're basically giving them the game plan whenever we react to a post. You see? So, like, you see a post where a black man is getting beat and killed by a fucking police officer, then you got all these people looking at it, all these views, you know, and then you got all these comments, and it's giving off this wave of energy, you know, and these people will manipulate that shit and use this against us, and they've shown us that. We're dealing with that shit with Robin Hood right now. Robin Hood is supposed to be a fucking democratic platform. Why the fuck this dude, he used to be a hedge fund CEO. You know what I'm saying? Now the hedge fund CEOs is calling this dude, making him stop selling shit. You know what I mean? Like, putting a freeze on it. Then they took it, AMC stock went up to like $20, 290% profit, right?
Yeah, I seen
that. Then they froze the shit, right? So then they didn't tell you when they were going to unfreeze it. They just told you that it was frozen. You know that you couldn't sell. So for a day, you couldn't sell. And your stock went from $20 to $6. Next morning, they woke up and sold all that shit at $6 a pop. Who the fuck bought that shit? It wasn't us. It was the big-ass fund, the big-ass hedge fund.
Hey, look, you know how I am. Listen, I want to go off subject for a second. It was a 9-year-old girl. She was 11. She invested $60 in GameStop, man. She made $3,000, man, when that stuff happened. You know what I mean? That was great, man. That was great.
Yeah, that was what we were going to. You know what I'm saying? It was a great market, and because now that the common man can get in this market and make money, you know, the powers that be have a problem with that. We are at we're fighting wars right now.
Yep.
You know what I mean? We got some battles that's going on. We're battling with the financial world. We're battling with the media. We're battling with politics. We're battling with the judicial system. You know what I mean? Like, there's some wars going on.
And you know they already said that the stock market is no more than a glorified casino. And you know why they say that? Because there's a lot of young black people investing now. So now they're going to call it a casino. Man, I tell you, boy, that's why I be telling you, LPZ. I know you don't play that nigga card, but that's what they think of us, bro. I don't give a fuck if we rich. Yeah. We poor, we the president, we the mayor, we the governor, we still a nigga. Flat out. I'm sorry.
But you sound like an accomplished nigga. You fucking mayor and governor and police officer and lawyer.
Still a nigga.
And CEO and whatever.
Still a nigga. I'm not black. I'm OJ.
I give a fuck. You know, you better stand on something. I don't give a fuck. And this is what I say, though. You know, and this, it ain't that I don't play the nigga shit. It's like, hey, I know what niggas do. I know I can turn into a nigga. You know what I'm saying? Flip right back into one. But what I'm saying is, I give a fuck what you think of me. What you look at me and you think of me has no bearing on who I am.
No.
You know what I'm saying? That's in your motherfucking mind. As long as you keep that shit in your head, I ain't got no problem with you, bro. As soon as you put that shit outside your face, you know what I'm saying? Then I have a, you know, I have some decisions to make. You know what I'm saying? Am I offended to the point where I feel like I have to correct you? Or is this so silly to me I can laugh at you and keep walking on? Right now, I'm valued at way too much to be fucked up about some shit that's going on inside your head. I'm just going to keep it moving. You know what I'm saying? Whether you see me as a nigga or not, my money's been green, and if you want to make some money, then you need to fuck with me. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You ain't talking about no money, then we ain't got shit to talk about. If I move next door to a motherfucking racist and shit, as long as his ass stay on his side of the fence, I stay on my side of the fence, we ain't got no issue.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Once you cut the puppet strings off, those, you know, when the man can't control you no more, and you grow, your growth goes so far as you cutting them puppet strings off, like the great Dr. Martin Luther King and Malcolm X, when they can't control you, you gotta go. See, back in the 60s, they was killing you. I guess in the 2020 millennium or the 2000 millennium, yeah, they just sabotaging you. You know what I mean? They're sabotaging you, man. I mean,
they,
man,
your baby, sabotaging your motherfucking leadership.
Yeah. They was letting them get off too easy in the 60s. They were just killing them. You know what I'm saying? We're going to take you out your misery. Now they just fucking your life up. You know what I mean? And I sure hope they don't do that shit to Cube, man. Because I just hope they don't do that to Cube, man. But I think he on that list, man. Shout out to T.I., man. T.I., I'm with you, baby. I believe in you, T.I. Don't let me down. Don't let no bullshit come out later on that you did this. Because I don't think you did it, bro. You know what I mean? He didn't deny.
Huh? And then I seen so many other little YouTube, I guess the little YouTube commenters or reactionals or whatever the fuck they dudes be doing. I don't really want to call no names and shit.
Right.
Because it's a personal thing. Right. You know, but y'all some bitch-ass niggas, man. Y'all some faggot-fuck-ass niggas. The way that y'all fucking ride dick just makes me unearthed. You know, like, whenever a person does something, instead of coming to his aid, you make jokes of it, and you perpetuate the shit, like, play it over and over and over.
Add fuel to the fire.
Yes.
Because they
you
never...
You know what I'm saying? Like, you vetoed this shit. Like, shit is okay with you,
hey.
Man.
You ever? I know somebody. Hey, you ever? Somebody told you, LPZ, Tyrus, I'm pulling for you. I'm praying for you. Them the motherfuckers you need to watch. They ain't bit more praying for you, and they ain't bit more pulling for you. They just say it because it sounds good, man. And them the type of motherfuckers I want out of my life, man. Poison motherfuckers, man. You know what I'm saying? A motherfucker call and check on you to see if you fail yet. They say they calling to check on your welfare, but they actually call to see if you in the welfare line yet. That's, you know what I mean? If you get what I'm saying.
Yeah. It was fucked up because, you know, a year or so ago, man, I was in that motherfucking line too.
Right.
You know what I mean?
But you came up out that motherfucker smelling like roses.
Yeah, man. You know, Kobe was a motherfucker for a lot of people.
Yeah.
And I was just coming off the reserve and shit. So, you know, the quality of life is so expensive nowadays.
It was
and just being able to get
COVID.
And then COVID came.
Hey.
And that
COVID
shit stopped all checks from coming.
COVID was a reset button. COVID 2020, it was a reset button year, man. You had to push the reset button. You know what I mean?
But think about it like this. You sitting at the crib, right?
Yep.
And a motherfucker call you, he owe you $20,000. He telling you, oh, I'll have it for you in the morning. Then the shit with the COVID shit happens, and he decides not to pay you because of COVID.
Right.
He don't know what the fuck's going to happen. You know what I'm saying? He don't know if everybody's going to turn into zombies. He don't know if he calls you back next week and your ass dead. You know
right. What I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? So, from COVID. No from money. COVID. He's trying to wait it out
nobody
and see if you catch COVID. Right.
Nobody bills not paid. You know what I'm saying? All money transactions stopped, came to a halt.
Yep.
It was horrible. You know what
definitely
I mean?
Definitely did.
Shit. Yep. You know, so, you know, it's always a humbling space, man. You know, and the universe and God, our creator, is great at showing you, you know what I'm saying, just that. You know,
right.
How humbling life is. Life can be great and life can be beautiful, but you have to be grateful for life. And
right.
Once you become grateful for it, you can enjoy it. You know what I'm saying? But
right.
If you abuse it in any kind of way, you know what I'm saying? That shit will humble the fuck out of you. You know, you get this godly complex to where you want your whites to bow down and shit. And because you a white man and you 6'7" and this black woman is 5'3" and you want her to bow down to you, when that story goes the fuck out, that is not going to sound good for you and you're going to lose all your shit.
You losing
you're
everything. Fucking idiot. You're a fucking
you know
idiot,
saying?
Man. Take his ass back to the hills.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because you had the godly effect and forgot what the fuck the world was or what you meant to the world.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Shit, same shit. Had it would have been a black man and a white woman, his career would have been fucked up, except he would have went to prison.
Oh, yeah. Oh, shit. This motherfucker might go to prison. But, you know what I mean? But for sure, a black man, you know, they put a black man in prison for fighting pit bulls. So what the fuck? You know what I mean? But anyway, man, that's another subject for another day, man. You got any closing remarks? We're running out of time here.
Yeah. Be Entertainology LLC is official. We are coming for you. Technology is the new wave. I am here now, bitches. Billionaire Bruce Wayne. The reason they call me Billionaire Bruce Wayne is because I have this big-ass brain, and I know what to do with it. I would like to say thank you for everybody that tuned in tonight. Uncle T, Terrence Sales, Big Baby, appreciate platform. Enjoy being here every time. See y'all next week. Same place, same bat channel.
Shout out to Media Made Music. Shout out to Media Made Magazine, man. I want to thank my man San Lawrence for giving this opportunity to do what we do on this platform, man. And I also, Black History Month, man. Make this a great month, man. It's the shortest, fastest month on the calendar. So make it count. Make it count, black man. Shit, man. And once again, like I always tell everybody, stop falling for the smoke and mirrors. Stop falling for the banana in the tailpipe bullshit, man. Shit, the hood gotta save the hood, man. Shit, shit. Great show, LPZ. Shout out to T.I., man. I hope you get that situation under control. And, because we're another black man biting the dust, man. We don't want that. Let me see. Oh, yeah, we got the, well, I'm going to play it as we going off. The artist, the Flint artist of the day, MDGM Smooth out of Bucktown. I like that young nigga, man. He got a lot of potential, man. Red Guys record label, man. They out in Bucktown. They doing some They doing some epic shit out there, man. Shout out to YNJ, the Coochie Man. Shout out to YSR Grams. Shout out to Crispy Life Kid. Shout out to Mo B, man. Out there with Energy Beats. When I tell you Energy Beats is doing it, he's everywhere. He in a lot of different genres, not only rap. And he doing his thing, man. You know what I'm saying? Hey, man, we out of here, LPZ.
All right, Femo.
Peace.
Like, why do you niggas, like, always in competition? Like, can't no niggas just be doing good? Like niggas just gotta be doing better.
Shout out Bucktown.
Y'all just gotta be doing better, huh?
You worry about another nigga, boy, you gay as hell. I can't tell my story, nigga, it's too much to tell. Niggas do some gangster shit to turn around and tell. Put a hit on a nigga, get him killed in jail. Lost Trump, then meets, yeah, the streets owe me. Ain't never had no big homie, ain't no nigga coach me. Just gotta stick to the call, won't let no nigga on me. Don't give a fuck them niggas did, them niggas gotta show me. I told my mama I'ma get us rich and I meant that shit. I couldn't do it playing ball, I gotta get to a brick. I know my mama mad as hell that I ain't go legit. Now I'm too deep up in the streets, I just can't up and quit. Jail calls with my dog, we just reminisce. We just reminisce. I'm vending this bitch. Fuck vending.
Bitch, you talking too much, shut up and roll this wood. I hate a bad bougie bitch, I hate Megan Good. I would be high, we be 10 deep through your hood. Niggas out here with fake hemmies, nigga, pop your hood. I know I'm light skinned, but don't get shit confused. They say I'm bad as hell, but I think I'm misunderstood. I done pop two vices, bitch, I'm activated. If I pull this fucking phone, I'ma get the acting brazy. They say I got a little money, now I'm acting shady. When I was down on my knuckles, ain't nobody save me. Two clips on that Drake, I hope dog praying. I finna put his ass right to where his dog land. You ain't gon' never hear my name, so about what dog said. Can press the button on any nigga, just give me dog head. Bumpy Justin for real, you know I dog play. Yeah, man. Hey, blood. We go brazy at this bitch. The blood way.
Rocking with the number one podcast in Flint, Michigan. Flint After Dark. We speak for the streets. Hosted by your boy Terrence Sales. We speak for the streets.
Welcome to Flint Town City.